Fertilizer is a necessary component of nursery production that is typically expensive and also poses environmental risks if not used properly. By selecting an appropriate fertilizer and integrating fertilizer management with other aspects of production for efficient nutrient use, nurseries can become more economically and environmentally sustainable. Fertilizer must be applied to container-grown crops because nursery substrates provide few, if any, nutrients and have low nutrient-holding capacity. The limited container volume restricts the quantity of nutrients that can be held, and frequent irrigation leaches nutrients. These factors make it difficult to provide adequate levels of nutrients for plant growth without over-fertilizing or leaching nutrients, losing them in runoff and potentially polluting surface waters. Environmentally sustainable solutions to this dilemma are to apply soluble fertilizers as needed or use slow-release sources. Dry soluble sources can be applied by hand to each container or mixed in solutions and applied with irrigation. Fertilizing via overhead irrigation risks wasting fertilizer because of irrigation falling between pots. Other irrigation systems, such as ebb and flow, efficiently apply, recapture, and reuse these nutrients.
Here at James Greenhouses, we use an ebb and flow irrigation system, and this is the heart of it. Basically, our well water is pumped into storage tanks. From the storage tanks, once a bench is turned on, the pumps are activated and the water is pulled from the storage tank into a mixing tank, where fertilizer is added according to a preset EC level. From here, the water and fertilizer is mixed and it heads out to the bench. The fertigated water is transferred to each individual bench from the mixing tanks. And each bench runs for approximately 6 minutes, and it's approximately 120 gallons total. And it's about a 12-minute soak time per bench. So all the water contains all the fertilizer and is at the correct pH and EC at the time that it reaches the bench. Once the benches are finished watering and the water begins to drain, we collect it all in a sump pump and it is all returned back to our storage tank where it is then ready to be used again for the next irrigation cycle.
Other efficient irrigation systems, such as low volume sprinkler heads or micro irrigation, result in slower application of irrigation. Proper management of these systems will reduce the potential for fertilizer leaching through containers. Slow-release fertilizers, either synthetic or organic, improve nutrient use efficiency by gradually releasing nutrients over a period of months. Synthetic slow-release fertilizers usually are dry fertilizers coated with urea, sulfur, resins, polymers, or other materials. These coatings release nutrients at rates primarily dependent on temperature and moisture. Sophisticated coating technology allows precise release rates such that the grower can select a product that matches the nutrient needs and production cycle of a crop.
Hey Alan, tell me a little bit about your fertilizer program here at Grand Flora.
Well, a long time ago, we went to using slow-release fertilizer that we incorporate into our soil mix. And because we have so many different products that we put out, trees, shrubs, ground covers, vines, perennials, annuals, we have different formulations for each of the different soils. So our shrubs and trees, which are going to stay in the pot a long time, we use a 12-month slow-release fertilizer in that soil mix. The perennials, which usually are out of here in a few months, we use a 6-month fertilizer, just enough that it'll stay good and keep releasing when it's in a retail nursery or in the ground. And then for our annuals, we actually incorporate a 3-month fertilizer.
While these products greatly improve nutrient use efficiency, they are expensive due to the energy required for production of synthetic fertilizers.
Well, they are more expensive, but you save money on labor because you're not having to go around every 2 months and put fertilizer on the top of the pot. With liquid fertilizers in the greenhouse, they'd have to be hand watering with an injector or something every week. I mean, that takes a lot of energy. I think that there's money savings by in putting it in the soil. Even in an annual growing operation, with 4-inch pots, you can use a slow-release fertilizer. Here we have a 3-month fertilizer. These plants will probably be sold within 2 months. That means even when they're on the shelf in a retail nursery, they'll hold up and keep feeding for another month. It's very common when you sell your plants to a retailer that they don't continue to fertilize. And if you've given them liquid fertilizer all their life and then they go to a retail nursery, they're gonna start getting yellow and they'll start to fail. So here, just dibbling a little hole in the corner and putting the slow-release fertilizer in, will get feeding throughout the life of the plant.
Organic fertilizers often are manufactured from agricultural, marine, or animal byproducts, including plant waste, manures, blood, and bone meal. These products are bulky and typically have low nutrient content and decompose to release nutrients at rates dependent on temperature, moisture, microbial activity, and characteristics of the organic material. The low nutrient content and bulkiness of these products make them better suited for field nursery production. If used in containers, they often must be incorporated into substrates at rates comparable to substrate components. While doable, the combination of organic fertilizer and substrate must be matched to the crop and production conditions, and supplemental fertilizer still may be necessary to produce commercially acceptable crops. A carefully planned and properly implemented nutrient management program can improve container nursery crop production, produce healthy plants, and be both environmentally and economically sustainable. To find additional information, please refer to this document and others which are available on the project website.